Hello YouTube, and welcome to another PC build log that centers around a video game. Today's game brings LEGO fans and Star Wars fans together. It's LEGO Star Wars The Force Awakens. Comes out June 28th, next week. That's just right around the corner. I'm pretty excited because these games are just a lot of fun. They're not too hard, they're not too easy, they're just kind of goofy, and I don't know, it's exciting to play games that are just remind you of, like, kind of the Mario-esque, where you just jump in and you have a lot of fun. These kind of build videos that I do center around the PC minimum requirements, parts that are well-rated, brand new, available on the market, easy to get to. The system requirements on the screen now comes from Steam and systemrequirementlabs.com. A little note, for this build, the CPU, the Intel Core 2 Quad Q6600 is no longer available on the market. Sits at 2.4 gigahertz and 4 cores. The equivalent would be an Intel Core i5-4430. It's just keeping in the theme of quad-core CPU and being the cheapest and easiest to get to. Intel never comes all that cheap, so of course it's still kind of a little higher in price. The i5-4430 comes at 3 gigahertz as opposed to the 2.4 gigahertz and the Q6600. It's a bit of a bump, but, you know, you get what you get. On the AMD side, the Phenom X4 9850 is, of course, now no longer available on the market. Therefore, I went with the AMD FX 4300 Vishera quad-core 3.8 GHz CPU. Again, a big bump in gigahertz there from the 2.5 GHz to 3.8 GHz. The X4 9850 sits at 4 cores, and it's 2.5, just like I was saying. So it kind of sets the bar about where you want to aim for, hit that mark or higher, which is why I went with the one I went with, the FX 4300. And there's just not many choices on the AMD side, so this is about as close as I could get without getting something that's a complete piece of garbage. the GPU, the GeForce GT430, is of course not an option these days, but we can match its specs to a newer card almost identically. The GT730 has the same memory, CUDA cores, and core clock speed. It is not the best money well spent, I know, but for the purposes of matching the minimum system requirements as closely as possible, this card's perfect. A little note, the GT730 does come in a 2GB version for like the same exact price, so you could technically bump the performance for around a $2-3 change in price, which is pretty cool, actually, from NVIDIA for all guys who sometimes have weird choices at this kind of card tier level. Stepping away from NVIDIA, we look at AMD minimum, the HD 6850. Of course, you can't get this card right now. And it has some incredibly good specs. So to match up with these good specs is a bit difficult. It has 1 gig memory, 775 megahertz core clock, 960 stream processors, which is just really tough to find in a cheap card from AMD today. Therefore, I went with a more expensive card, the Radeon R7 370. It's double the memory at 2 gigs, but once you compare the core clock and stream processors, you see why I picked it. The core clock is 985 megahertz, and the stream processor is 1024. It's about as close as you can get to the HD 6850, and it's such a well-performing card that anything below an R7 370 is just, it falls short in some categories, so I had to go above and beyond with all of that. This game looks great. I'm excited. Check out the background footage that you're seeing right now. I mean, it looks pretty great. Hope you enjoy the video. If you have any questions about your PC setup, what about my builds or whatever, the prices look pretty good. It's not very expensive. AMD is a very cheap option for here. Thanks for watching and see you in the next build video.
That ship on our right.
That one's garbage.